Jim McCormick of AgMarket.net, our guest today. Jim, let's talk a little bit about this wheat market. Obviously, we're planting a winter wheat crop. The spring wheat, the Durham wheat crops were smaller than anticipated. We've got the dollar here in the mix and trying to get some global exports going. How does this all fit together?
Well, it all fits together kind of messily, plain and simple. The crop got smaller, which is kind of friendly right now, but then you got the dollar, which is moving higher. It broke out to the upside, which technically is not a good sign. As the dollar gets more expensive, it makes our products more expensive to sell. Right now, we are the most expensive product on the world right now on the international part as we're trying to export wheat. But on the other hand, Clint, when you see this supply get tighter, which is what it is, essentially what's going to happen is you got to keep the wheat high enough price that it doesn't become a feed ration. So in general, the wheat should be relatively supportive. The next thing we're going to be watching in here in our group is what's going on in the west, you know, in the Western Plains as planting ramps up. They're very dry right now. There is some rain in the forecast, but they're going to need some pretty good rains to get this, wheat out of the ground. Here in Northern Illinois, they are planting wheat, but they're planting it in some of the driest soils they've seen in multiple years, and we'll see what happens.
You know, that is interesting. And I also, we've been talking quite a bit about world food prices, and that seems to be a whole new dynamic as countries look to secure some of the, you know, global, their food needs.
Exactly. And that's where it gets really interesting on the overall geopolitics. China came out today, earlier this week, and said, hey, they're not going to export potash through the 2022 year. They're going to keep it for themselves. So as the world is getting scarce on food, and it's not just the scarcity, it's the logistics of getting it there. We saw what happened with Hurricane Ida. Knocked down some ports for a couple weeks, we lost some demand that we may not be able to get back. So no, this is a situation that the world is very worried about food inflation, and it's gonna take time to build back these supplies. And if we have any kind of a problem, South America's just starting to get this bean crop planted. If they don't get the crop planted, we saw what happened last year. Then they have problems with corn. They have problems with corn, then it really amps up our demand. So all this is all intertwined. It's far from over. It's going to be a very volatile year. But right now, you got to say the corn is a little bit optimistic, beans a little bit pessimistic, and wheat, I think, could be a little bit supportive.
All right. Sounds good, Jim. Sure appreciate that. Thank you so much for being here. We'll be back with more Ag Day coming up.